Hello, people. And today I'm gonna make a pet room, reptile slash fish room update for August. So I'm gonna start off with the reptiles today. So I'm gonna start with my leopard gecko and see if she wants to eat. Oh, it's just gonna dart off, I guess, but we'll get a look at her. Here she is. She's a tangerine, I believe, and I took out all the driftwood just now because she seemed cramped and she was always trying to escape with it in. So I'll get her something eventually, but here she is. She's kind of pissed off because I woke her up, but she's just in a tin with a heat pad right on there and superworms. I usually feed mealworms, but my parents bought superworms. Calcium. There's some calcium powder in there. And water. So, yeah. And her hide is a modified Trader Joe's yogurt thing. Very natural, I know, right? You guys are going to need to bear with me on this one, because it's going to be probably a long video. Probably about 10 minutes. So, grab some popcorn. Here is my, house gecko tank right next to her. She is actually in where we'll see. And she's never out. I think I've gotten like one picture. I think it's a female. She's always back in the tank. And I put the tank backwards. Just some speckled pothos. Calcium with a little mealworms. There's always a couple crickets around. Water. I'll spray it down a few times a day. This is normal pothos. It's like just this bright green. Just put my camera down on the water trying to get a better shot of the pothos. But it's okay. That's it for her. If you want to know what a house gecko looks like, they're pretty much just a miniature Chihuahua gecko. Which is like a crested gecko with no crest. Here are those compost jars. There's some leaves and stuff in there right now. Just some isopods and earthworms. And then I have a little 2.5 gallon terrarium with no animals in it, but I have some leaf litter. This fern, which is doing okay. This other fern, which is doing good. And, and this other plant. So now onto the fish. We're gonna start off with my Caracotta Matrialis. I don't think it's Crackodon because this is spelled right. I've checked a lot. Some people pronounce it Crackodon, but the RNA would have to be reversed. So I think it's Caracotta. Caracotta Matrialis, Rainbow Gudeid. I have seven? Wait. I have six. Started out with five. And this guy. Oh, I have really bad glare. The female is really pregnant. There's a not dominant male, another not dominant male, either a colorful female or a dull male, and the big male is he's the dominant one. He's always trying to mate, but she's pregnant, so I will get some new fry really soon. I'm really excited about that. I have some, it's trapped down there, but the water, I have some water sprite, and, Java moss, and Elodia, and other stuff. So that's them. So now on to my, community aquarium. I don't have, like, any substrate in this tank. It's just for show, so plant-wise, it's really dull. Once I get some more gravel, it's gonna look a lot nicer. Okay, so animal-wise, I have... Whoa, she's pretty. I'm getting some nice yellow on them. The Pelvicromus cyanus, I think? I don't know. Cremensis, Malawi strain. I think they're really pretty. And then some species like Capella, Splash Tetra, I don't think it's a true one because it's not getting the, these colors that males have. Or I just have two females. Sparkling Grommies, I have three of these. Vietnamese White Claw Mountain Minnows. These are awesome. I really love these fish. I'm going to try to breed them. I've bred normal white claws before. That's the male. There's a couple females. Here's one. And I have my lonely female strawberry betta, which needs a male, but the males were $20 at another place, so she was 10. And then I have some Amano shrimp and the dwarf frog, which I saw earlier today. It's probably over here. I don't know where he is, but you can look at some of my older videos. The Endler hybrids, I kind of like don't want to work with these anymore, so I'm gonna give them to my mom for her classroom tank, although I do really, really like this guy. So yeah, the tank is kind of in a process of like moving. Now this is something I'm happy about, was working on this for the past couple days. It's not done. I'm gonna add another tank right here, but the pond guppies are some endlers. So this tank needs to grow in. I'll get more in depth of that in a second. That tank is clearly grown in, and then I have a picture of a poison dart frog. I really love this print. Dentrobates, I think, right? Yeah, I don't know. I'm not good with dart frogs, but yeah. So I set up a new tank yesterday. No, these are not my, what are they called? They're not the Multifusiatus. Those are at my dad's house. This is all at my mom's. So they won't be in this video. But I got some new guppies. They're like orange shine guppies, but not. And they were sold as endlers, but no, they're not. Here he is. I got a pair. They kind of look like a real Macho Lago strand. I'm hoping she doesn't look orange line like the dad or the male. And she looks more wild type guppy like. So I'll get some weird combination. So yeah, plant wise or scape wise, it's ugly. I just have this white ugly gravel. So I have these rocks I got pretty much up in Canada. I got this it's really, really north US in Washington, and then some coral from Hawaii. This plant I got out of a pond. I washed it and everything. I got out of a pond where it was growing submerged, and it was really pretty. There was like a ton of them, so I think it will do well. And then I have some valves and some Landrinia, some Java moss, some old world bulb plant, a Indian almond leaf that hasn't decided to sink yet, and some duckweed, and some dwarf water lettuce. If I don't grow, well, yeah, he's starting to get some really pretty colors. You can see that line. I like that a lot. So I'm hoping maybe those kids will be a little more pronounced, like have that trait more than the orange, because I have a tank. This tank is only for the orange. So this is my El Salto Rio Macho Lago orange wine guppy tank. I just said a ton of stuff in Spanish. So there's a male, pretty awesome. I have a ton of them. There's a ton of little fry up. Now I think they came forth the other day again. There's some up there. This melon sword, man, I love this. I like it a lot more than Amazon swords, which the only one I've managed to keep alive and good is in my Gudian tank, actually. I probably saw it, I don't remember. This red plant, I still don't know what it is. It's kind of turning green, but I like it. I moved some into the main 10-gallon. Yeah, I love the leaf with the wild guppies. Just think that's cool. And then I put some Amano shrimp in there and took some of all the algae out. Bleh. And then with these two tanks, maybe not this one, but probably this one, I want to get some Danios, like, Celestial, Pearl Danios, Galaxy Reservoirs, those. Or, maybe, Danio Eurymythica? I don't know. They're like those, but they're strict. They're really pretty. And they're super small. I think the second one I said, I think, is endangered. But I've seen them a lot. Yeah. There's the sword I was talking about in the Gideon tank. There's the baby. Kind of. Yeah. So I'm gonna go out to the ponds now, and yep. It might be a little loud up there because they're building a house across the street, so yep. Here is Riley, and I totally forgot to show the hamster. I will do that at the last. And here she, here. Yeah. Okay. Yep. So here's a guppy pond of like thick green water. Oh, I don't think. Oh, there's a fish, but I don't know. Just wild feeder guppies. Nothing special. Yeah, there's a ton in there. Here's a white club pond. I was searching for fry yesterday. I didn't find any, so I don't think they bred this year. Saw some adults the other day. And arrowhead's doing good. Flowering. Yep. And here's a body pond. It's doing the best. The grass plant's doing awesome. And, this is what happens when hornwort goes outside. Oh, it gets huge. So, there's an arrowhead plant starting to grow in here. And Lindrunia, talking about some other plant. This thing. And then, so yeah, I harvest plants for tanks and stuff too. So, yep. And to end, here's the hamster. Campbell's. Winter white hybrid, I think. Most likely. Here she is. I can't see her. She's like, what the hell is going on? So I'm not really that interested in mammals anymore. I'm gonna mainly stick with fish and reptiles now. Yep. And yep, so that's it. Tomorrow night, I get to go see Jack White at the concert. I'm really, really freaking happy about that. And so, yeah, I'm pretty, yep, I think that's it. And see you in the next vid. So, see ya. Bye.